Hi, welcome to week four of Magoos Corner. I'm your host, Trevor Greg, and I'm joined by the illustrious Tom Lipson. Hello, mate.
Hi, Trev.
What we do, we go through the results of last week and also preview next week's games, thanks to australiasports.com. That's Australia with an S, and the SA Footballer magazine. So make sure you subscribe and get sent the 160-page book of goodness every week. Have you had a look at it yet?
Yes, and every day I read it.
So have I, because it takes a little bit to go through, but once you get to the end, you will never look back. So what we've got now is we've got Elizabeth, who took on Blackfriars up at Argana Park, and it was 15-11, 101 to Blackfriars, 3-6-24.
I think it's going to be great. Elizabeth, I think they played in the prelim last year, or semi or prelim, so the bees have been pretty good for a while now, so not surprising there.
For Elizabeth, we had Casey with 5, Millwood with 3, Tully with 2, and also Stuart with 2. Best players were Druitt, Stuart, Packham, Casey and Lomas.
Stuart,
Packham and Casey. We had Blackfriars with Sanford, Curtis and Clark. And best players were Picaro, Rivett and Curtis. So we had a nice job by Elizabeth.
Could be.
Then we had the Dolphins. This is Damien Leonard's favourite team, taking on Woody South at the East Parklands. So not like the South Parklands, the East South Parklands, where they're much more of a higher standard. We're 14-9-93. CBC to Woody South 7-8-50.
Good win. I think Woody South struggling a little bit. They seem to be doing really well or really badly, don't they? Mm. I think Primus, they're kicking 5 for CBC. He's a good A-grade player for a long time. He's a big unit up forward, so that's handy to have him running around.
Woody South had Ames with 3, Talak with 2, and Swanson Coombe getting in there. And best players with Tory Williams, if it is the same man. Smith, Ames, Simpsons, and Dankovic also getting in there on the best players. Still think Tory's better than Division 5.
I would think so. Mm-hmm. Played in Division 3 A grade grand final 4 years ago. He was playing B grade for himself. You think he'd be good enough to make that A grade team?
Yeah, he did. And that's a big thing that's happening at the minute with mates. But people just wanted to play with their mates.
Yeah,
that's all
it is. Probably right.
A lot of blokes trying to shut themselves around. Cox paying for money. But yeah, so Primus for 5, Nicholson, Clark, Yates and Bilby. And best players for CBC were Brown, Primus, Renfrey. So nice work out there for CBC. And the next one, we had Colonelite Gardens taking on Rosewater. So this is very much a different result, and I think I know why. Colonelite Gardens 12-16, 88 to 2-6-18. And I'm looking through here, Tommy. No Johnson Schroeder.
No Johnson Schroeder.
No Johnson Schroeder, no Roadrunner.
SJS.
But just
came out.
That
was good
though, yeah. Bobwell with 3, Snell with 3, Thompson with 2, and in the best players for Colonelite Gardens was Brown, Snell, Manigan.
Tony Shams.
And Shambles still in the B grade. Is he rocking up for training?
Wouldn't have thought.
No. Wyland and Todd Shannon with goal kickers, and Cooper, Page, Cooper, Petrozelli, and Shaw. So still reckon Tony Shambles is better than Division 4 reserves.
Oh, that'd be poor delivery for him to only kick one goal.
You would have thought for 2-6, or he kicked all 6 points.
He must have.
So, yeah, hurry up and pull your finger out, Shambles. Next one was Adelaide Lutheran taking on Green Acres in the South Parklands, my favourite spot. 7-16-58, 2 Green Acres, 5-4-34.
Luthies played finals last year in Division 5, they're B grade, so not surprising that they're doing okay. It's probably the only decent thing about Adelaide Lutheran at all. They're B grade.
And yeah, I mean, we played them a few years ago, and our C's have played them recently as last year and so on. But Green Acres again saw them against Rosewater, and they still haven't recovered from then. So I think Green Acres are going to have a very tough year. Ludwig with 2, Exton, Borgus, and Lane. And best players for Luthies was Ludwig, Lane, Jenke, Borgus, and Yateman. And for the Dragons, we had Cum with 2, Lamb, and Carver. And best players were Dawson, Carver, and Rankmore.
The Dragons.
The Rankmore. Now, the last game, we had Parry Hills take on Pulteney. So, this was out at the Paddocks. Not a good result for Parry Hills. Pulteney 15-18, 108 to Parry Hills 4-3-27. Yeah. Wowza.
Parry Hills struggling for a few years now with the B grade, I think. So, a lack of depth there is probably why the A grade is been struggling as well for the last couple of years. So, Pulteney seem to have got their stuff together. They're travelling along nicely, the whole club, so well.
I think there's a lot of clubs around that do look after one specific part of the club, which is just detrimental to how a club should grow. So, Pulteney, Pete with 5, Kaleski with 3, Bauer with 2, and a whole row of others. Curry, Marsland, Kaleski getting in the best players. And for Para Hills, it was Ryan with 2, Norris and Jones chipping in with 1 apiece. McKellar, Ryan, Hughes, Verd and Garden for Para Hills. So, tough day out for Para Hills, so hopefully they can get the job done against a more localised opposition next week in Greenacres. So we'll start with them, Greenacres versus Para Hills at Edward Smith.
Greenacres, but that would be a pretty sloppy game to watch, I reckon.
Sloppy. Sloppy. There won't be a spread of goal scorers in
sloppy that spread of goal sloppy. Scorers.
Yep, so I'm going to ask Para Hills to get the job done. I'm going to ask them to get the job done. Elizabeth, Adelaide Lutheran at Argana Park, so another good drive.
Elizabeth by a bit, I would say.
Yeah, I think it's the Adelaide Lutheran will play the game in their head too many times and figure out how to get out there safely. So Elizabeth for me. Rosewater take on CBC at Eric Sutton.
Rumbles to kick 9 on the ball. Rumbles to win.
Yeah, Todd Shannon.
Big week on the track.
Another big game. Yep. Get there, both guys. CBC for me, unfortunately. Pulteney versus Colonel Light Gardens. This will be a good one. And Morgan Oval.
Colonel Light for me. They're pretty impressive. They've been great last year and the year before. So, yeah, hard to go past them, I reckon.
And recruited well again in the off-season too, I've heard. Yeah. Same for me, Colonel Light. And Woody South versus Blackfriars. So, one of the dogs.
Hounds.
The Hounds?
I don't even know what colours of Black Friday are.
Yeah, no, they're black.
I thought a draw.
Yeah. Versus the Cats, so I think Black Friday for me.
Nil or draw.
Nil or a draw. Wow. Alright, so we'll use that. And on that note, that was Division 5 Reserves for this week. We'll catch you again next week, and make sure you look out for AustraliaSports.com and the SA Football Magazine.